Yeah, keep an eye out tonight and tomorrow, because I'm going to be giving you guys way more details on how you can win that PC. As for people that are considering building a computer from the ground up for Star Citizen, you could totally, like, when Star Citizen releases, just update your graphics card or something like that, because, again, this game is constantly evolving because it's in development. So, bear in mind that when the game releases, I don't know, you may not have the perfect materials or the perfect hardware to play the game, but you can always just, like, upgrade your graphics card. That's the nice thing about computers is it's modular. So if there is something that needs to be updated, you can do that pretty easily. I was bleeding out anyway, there was no way I'd survive that.
Control point contested. Control point contested. Control point lost.
Someone said I want that case, man. You haven't even seen it yet. Contested. You'd like it though. It's really, really cool. I actually, I've seen it. Well, you'll find out tomorrow what it looks like, because I got video footage of it, but it looks awesome. It really does, and it's small. It's so small. Yet it can fit 1080 inside of it, which is currently the biggest, most powerful card there is. And it's apparently got great cooling. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. I should have watched my 6. Or my 9 o'clock. We almost acted. I mean, we're in the lead. We got 212 points. They got 75 points. Yeah. Even if we just kept objective B, I think that we're too far in the lead. Lose at this point. Yeah, maybe not actually. Because with all the objectives that they have, they could take B back and just keep the rest. Possibly. Yeah, they're up to 95. Yeah, they could actually win this thing. So let's focus. I'll go after Victor C.
Bet they didn't like that.
Where the hell is bullets coming from? You know what? Don't ask questions you don't know the answers to. If anybody gets the reference from that quote, super kudos to you. Maybe I'll skew the giveaway to be biased in your favor. Yeah, I won't do that, but seriously though, kudos. Kudos if you get it. Oh shit, that was a grenade. Oh, that was a grenade! Yes! Yes! We gotta run though. We gotta run. I got a couple of Marines on my ass. Oh shit. Nice. Still third place. 15 kills, 3 deaths. And that is victory. Ultimate victory, in fact. Oh yeah, Spaceman. This music is incredible. You haven't even heard some of the best of it yet. I got my favorite tracks. It's very Mass Effect-y, good way. It's unique though. I mean, you wouldn't mistake it for Mass Effect, but it's got that like ear pleasure effect. It pleasures your ears. I like that in a song. I like that music. I sort of have pretty diverse taste. You know, like some metal or industrial. I don't know what you call the music soundtrack, but I love that. Like some classic rock, progressive rock, Mass Effect music, whatever that's called, whatever this is called, the music from Tron Legacy. Some folk music, pop music, 80s especially, all kinds of music, but Star Citizen is really special. It's not generic either, which is... I mean, I like some of the tracks in Star Trek a lot, like the new Star Trek, but some of them are kind of generic feeling. You don't feel that with Star Citizen's music. Some of it's really good, though. I can't remember the title is one track, but it's really inspiring. Anyway, let's check out some of these ships. Let's go to Crusader. So in 2.6, loading screens are way faster. UI's updated. Check it out. Look how fast it is. It used to be like 3 minutes exactly waiting to load through, but now I think it's under 60 seconds. Damn good. Of course. I mean, it could be faster if they wanted it to be. It's just not a priority. Again, you're not meant to play this as a game. You're meant to test with this. But some information on my ship, my boy, the Caterpillar, one of the largest ships in Star Citizen. The Drake Caterpillar is a really interesting ship. It's a sprawling modular spacecraft which appears somewhat like its namesake. It's kind of like Caterpillar. It is for legitimate commerce and extended search and rescue missions. But at the end of the day, the Caterpillar is truly the evil twin of the Freelancer. Mainly because this perfectly legitimate commerce ship is used by pirates, primarily.
Ah, damn it!
We're in Grim Hex.
Son of a bitch!
I totally forgot about this. We did a bad thing in our last Star Citizen live, and we did something we shouldn't have done. And, yeah, we're paying the price for that now because, we're in this dump. We're in this dive. It's kind of like Nowhere from Guardians of the Galaxy. I don't know if you've ever seen Guardians of the Galaxy. If you haven't, do yourself a favor. Pick it up from Redbox. Watch it on Netflix, wherever it is. Watch it, because it's good. It's really good. Star Citizen's universe is like a combination of... It's a good universe. It's actually interesting. It's not like some sci-fi channel miniseries interesting. It's actually good. It's like a combination of Star Trek, Star Wars, Guardians of the Galaxy, all those things mixed into one, but pretty damn grounded in reality. Regardless, this place is pretty much like Nowhere. It's dangerous, you get shoot. The reason why it's called Grim Hex is because this has been repurposed. It used to be a Hex living facility. Kind of like the Bronx, kind of like Detroit. It's like cheap housing, affordable housing, space motel, basically. Until it was converted to basically like a pirate spaceport, which is what it is now. It has gone full Detroit. You never want to go full Detroit. We could easily be killed. As soon as we step out that airlock, nothing's protecting us. This is not Port Alistair. We don't have any sort of protection. We're going bareback. Mr. Caterpillar. There you are. So, this is shit. Well, that is a damn shame. Alright, all the pads are full. What I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to step outside and take out one of these starships. Oh, this is dangerous. I shouldn't be doing this. Better get our guns ready. Alright, sun's out, guns out. My assault rifle anymore. I don't know where it went. Probably pickpocketed. Okay. Clear. Ah, oh, there it is. What is this? What is it? Oh, it's a blade. It's not big enough. That son of a bitch has a gun out. He doesn't see me. He's shooting somebody else. Alright, he's dead. Gotta heal ourselves up. Beautiful.
Oh my god! What the? What the? The hell is he? Was that a sniper? Was that a goddamn sniper?
I thought the guy that I was shooting at killed the guy that was shooting at him, but... we just saw the food chain of Star Citizen. Shit. I'm gonna see if the landing pads are empty now.
Yeah, yo, I got sniped!
B.Alex knows what's happening. Damn it, man. Damn it. Well, it looks like this is what's going down at Grim Hex right now.
I'm Mantooth. Oh, no reward? Dead, we got fucked up.
Yes, too many. Shot all my guns off.
Yo, I got sniped!
Seemingly incoherent, but a very telling story, nevertheless. Alright, while the elevator's coming down, I'm gonna show you the new bar. This is it. Currently can't buy drinks, because there's more important things to develop in the game right now, but you'll be able to buy drinks and hang out with your squad mates, or your faction mates. By the way, we actually have our own faction. If you guys want to join up, if you want to play Star Citizen with us when it releases, or even before it releases, maybe in 3.0, Our faction is called Massive G. I've got a link down in the description. And if you want to make a Star Citizen account so you can play the game when it's in, like, the free fly week, and you can fly all the ships for free, use my referral code down in the description, or anyone's referral code, to get an extra 5,000 in-game credits. Once this game releases, it's going to be like any regular game. You pay 60 bucks and that's it. You're not going to have a monthly fee. It's not going to be like World of Warcraft. It's... you pay it. You pay it 60 bucks, get your game, and that's it.
Son of a bitch!
Seriously, what about you? What about you? What about you?
Son of a bitch! Alright! She's getting upset!
Oh, we have a problem here. We have a big problem.
Shit.
Alright. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna test the ship out in another area. Instead of the universe, I'm gonna test it out. At Dying Star. Beautiful place actually, so it's all good. Not mad at all. I'm not upset. I actually wasn't sure which landing pad was large class. I thought the one that was empty was large class, but it wasn't.